Good evening and welcome. You're watching Trending Tonight with me, Sanket Upadhyay. Everybody knows, as far as the political developments are concerned, we're talking about Punjab. There are different camps. So you've got the G23 versus the Congress versus Sidhu versus Captain versus Chinni. This is just going on and on and on. But this is Punjab's story. If you look at Chhattisgarh, you've got the same problem, where now there is a crisis brewing again with MLAs coming to the national capital. In Rajasthan, there seems to be a crisis of leadership. In Kerala, a crisis of leadership. In UP, a crisis of having a base. Many leaders are jumping ship. And then you've got certain other players who are so far regional players trying to have national ambitions. And it is but obvious for any political party to think of a pattern of growth. So thus, you've got a Trinamool Congress expanding into Assam, expanding into Goa and other territories as well. And of course, as we know, the Aam Aadmi Party, which is also planning to contest elections in many states, including Goa, Gujarat, Rajasthan, UP, Punjab, and the list goes on and on. And even Uttarakhand for that matter. But the point is, where does this leave the opposition space and who gets to be at the steering wheel as far as the opposition car is concerned? There's a Congress versus Congress, a G23 which says we are not G Huzur Ji, we are G23. Great opposition to that comment also of Kapil Sibal. But with the way things are going, who will be the real opposition in 2024? If there is an opposition Gathbandhan or an opposition coalition, who will sit on the driver's seat? You can't have 10 drivers in a car, no? Let me ask that question straight away of my first guest, Sushmita Dev, leader of the Trinamool Congress. Very recently shifted to the TMC, was with the Congress all this while. Ms. Dev, thank you very much for your time. My first question, you've seen the utter chaos in your previous party. I'm sure you would not be elated or happy about this situation that the Congress party is in. But, you know, let me ask you this question on where does this leave the opposition space in this country? Which party takes the lead? A broken, shattered Congress or other regional players like your new party and maybe the Aam Aadmi Party?
You see, what I think is there are two dynamics here. If you think about it, the Bharatiya Janata Party is not in every state. You look at South, you look at Northeast, you look at Bihar, you know, there are many states in which BJP doesn't have a presence, actually. And then there are some states in which BJP is in a direct fight with the Congress. So there are those two situations. And on the other hand, there's a situation where, although Congress is in a direct fight with the BJP, there are many states in which Congress is absolutely nowhere. To give a few examples, Odisha, they are finished, they are zero. Tripura, they are nowhere. Most of the northeastern states, they are nowhere. And the latest addition is Assam. Now the question is, somebody has to fill up that vacuum for two reasons. It's politically the need of the hour, and two, people want an alternative. And your question is absolutely fair, that how is all of this going to come together and how is it going to pan out in 2024. But I think that our first fight is as the elections come. So which are the elections that are facing us? We are facing several states going into election in 22 and 23, and then comes the 24. So which is the battle we take on first? It has to be the state elections, assembly elections. And from what I can only speak for All India Trinamool Congress, they are going after doing proper surveys, knowing that where they are going, they can block the BJP, stop the BJP and not harm the other opposition. So that's how we are going about it, because that's the only set of elections that's facing us immediately. And that's the best way to fight them. Beat them at the state level and then take on 24.
Sushmita ji, my question when the Trinamool Congress decides to move to Goa and flex its muscles there, are we to assume that you have concluded or arrived at a conclusion that the Congress party will not be able to fight or have a chance with the BJP? and that is why you must step in to fill the vacuum? What about other players like the Aam Aadmi Party?
See, I can't reveal too much, but this is what I will say. We have done our homework and we are going to be a force to reckon with. We have been in dialogue with people for several months. We have done our homework on the ground. So I fully appreciate the fact that Aam Aadmi Party is there. I fully appreciate the fact that there's Congress there and BJP, of course, which is in the government. And we still think we have a very good chance.
Who heads the opposition space? I'm sure this thought must have crossed your mind. Does Congress still remain the principal opposition?
See, a lot depends on who's going to be your face in that state. How are you going to go about creating a narrative? And how will you show yourself as a strong leader at the state level and otherwise? And I think it's going to be a cohesion of forces at the state level, and Mamata Banerjee's face counts. It very much counts. She stands for credibility. She stands for good governance. She stands for inclusive politics, all of which the anti-BJP vote bank wants. Mm. So I think she's a very, very credible face, a credible party, and she's proved her mettle. She's proved her ability for good governance. And our homework tells us that we are going to be a force to reckon with. Of course, you can't take electoral politics for granted. Things can go wrong. But we are very, very optimistic and quite confident that we are going to be a force to reckon with, and we will help in every way to block the Bharatiya Janata Party.
I like this use of the word force to reckon with. You know, you leave the door ajar. You know,
want to sound arrogant and overconfident. That's not in my nature.
Yeah. Other words, you don't want to give me a number. You don't want to sound so confident that, you know,
I'm sure we'll do many more shows, and I will also give you numbers when the time
Lovely.
Is right. Let's wait for that.
Lovely. All right. Ms. Sushmita Dev, thank you very much for your time. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Okay. We also have Raghav Chadda, MLA and spokesperson of the Aam Aadmi Party, Mahesh Verma, leader of the BJP, and Sanjay Jha, former spokesperson of the Congress Party, but an independent political analyst. We'll have a lot to say about the way the Congress is as of this moment. Raghav Chadda, let me start with you. The situation in Punjab, we were just talking to Ms. Dev, her party has opened up a front in Goa. And let me ask you this question. Do you feel that there is this rush as of this moment to occupy the space that the Congress is not being able to fill? And principally, you only have two parties doing that. One is the TMC and the other the Aam Aadmi Party.
Look, first of all, I do believe that the Congress Party is now an old and a frail, fledgling political party. Congress is also a very convenient opposition for the BJP. BJP would love to have Congress as its principal opposition. And Mr. Rahul Gandhi, is perhaps Prime Minister Modi's single biggest asset. It's very easy for him to project Rahul Gandhi as his principal challenger and win every goddamn fight. Now, as far as Aam Aadmi Party is concerned, we are a political party that has formed the government in Delhi successively three times. We are the principal opposition in the state of Punjab. I am speaking to you from the city of Ludhiana, where the Honorable Chief Minister of Delhi today had a wonderful dialogue with the traders. In Punjab is, of course, one of the states where Aam Aadmi Party has massive presence, robust organization, and every opinion poll is showing that we are in pole position to victory. And as far as other states are concerned, Goa and Uttarakhand in particular are two states where Aam Aadmi Party is putting all its might. And I do see that in each of these states where the Aam Aadmi Party enters, challenges the BJP, Congress starts receding. Aam Aadmi Party occupies the space of the principal challenger to the BJP. And you see that the Bharatiya Janata Party has to make changes and has to indulge in tectonic shifts, including replacing chief ministers in Gujarat and Uttarakhand, etc. Now, as far as who is in the driving seat is concerned, let me tell you, Sanket, wherever the people of the state are troubled by this, you know, this process of oscillation between the BJP or this musical chairs between the BJP and the Congress, they are yearning for an alternative, for a change. And Aam Aadmi Party is filling that void, is becoming that alternative. The Kejriwal model of governance, what we've done in Delhi, is something that the people of this country appreciate and want in their respective state governments. Now, who will be the face, etc.? I am not saying, I mean, this is, of course, nobody is going to answer that. It's a sheer arithmetic who gets the numbers. But as far as 2024 is concerned, it's far, far away. Let's take one state at a time. Aam Aadmi Party is a party that has very humble origins. We came from an Andolan. All of us are people who came from, you know, professional backgrounds. We left our careers because we wanted to bring in change. We wanted to do something for the country, including our boss, including our chief minister, our leader, who was a serving IRS officer and income tax commissioner. He left his lucrative job. He could have done whatever he wanted to do with his life, earned as much money as he wanted to, enjoy the niceties of life, but the luxuries of his life. He left all of that.
No, but Raghav, many leaders will have such stories to tell. For instance, Mamata Banerjee will have her story to tell that, look, I'm such a street fighter, which she is. She defeated the BJP in West Bengal. She said that, her party is projecting her as this big leader of the opposition space. And the way they're expanding into Goa, now these are territories which will make you uncomfortable.
Look, first of all, it is for the people of the state to decide. Number one. Number two, on your limited point of Goa, Aam Aadmi Party has been for the last few years working very, very hard in the state of Goa. In fact, very recently, a couple of weeks ago, an opinion poll done by a leading news channel showed that while the Bharatiya Janata Party enjoys the largest vote share in the state of Goa, Aam Aadmi Party is second, and we have left Congress behind, and Congress is a distant third. So in Goa, the challenge, the competition now is between the BJP and the Aam Aadmi Party, and the demise of the Congress in Goa has ensured the entry and a bumper entry of the Aam Aadmi Party.
Demise or reduction of the Congress party benefits which political party? Sanjay Jha, I want to come to you now. See, the point is to anyone who says that there is no opposition, the thing with opposition is that if there is no opposition, then there will be opposition from within. That is how the nature of politics is. Mr. Sanjay Jha, do you think that the Congress party willingly is giving up that space with each passing day? With each passing day, there is one more incident where the Congress is moving away from being that principal opposition space in this country. Or do you feel that this is some massive churning happening, that once all of this happens, Team Rahul will take over and suddenly we'll see the prospects of a Congress party skyrocket?
Well, Sanket, first and foremost, a personal request. Please don't be so formal. Call me Sanjay. I think we just tend to become, I don't use the word G. I think politicians are like every other person. So let's have exactly my point. Yeah. That was exactly what I was coming to. Now, I want to make a bigger point here that, before I answer your question, that it's rather rich on the part of my friend Raghav, who I think is an outstanding spokesperson for the Congress, to talk about AAP as if it is the alternative for the country. I don't know whether he's aware, but the Aam Aadmi Party was born out of an RSS-sponsored Arvind Kejriwal Anna Hazare agitation. But I don't want to get into that right now. But the simple answer is that the Congress Party has managed the extraordinary feat of self-destructing with impeccable, shall we say, execution. It's frankly speaking, a lot of us who are, being part of the Congress and, continue to be, strong ideological supporters are very dismayed or despondent with the way Punjab has been handled. Sanket, I can understand if the Congress was in 12 states and we were trying to juggle with some kind of a political experiment. But when you have been virtually annihilated all over the country, you just got barely a few states. And in each and every state, we have allowed these dissensions to, frankly speaking, ridicule what the party stood for once upon a time, which was transparent democracy. So Rajasthan has had the same problem. Chhattisgarh continues to be on a boil. Karnataka, we all know, has also had very serious issues. Kerala now has become a problem area. And Gujarat, I think Raghav is quite right, We have ceded space in places like Gujarat and Goa. Absolutely bang on. And I think this is the tragedy of India's opposition. Because I've been attending a lot of these dinners and, you know, all these confabulations that have happened. And every one of them agrees that if the BJP has to be defeated, and the BJP can be defeated, Mr. Modi's performance in the second term, notwithstanding what the cheerleaders of the government might say, have been nearly disastrous. COVID, economy, unemployment, the issues are laundry list of them. And yet, if the opposition is weak, and that was your question, I believe the Congress party needs to take responsibility for it. And I think this is really the tragic commentary of India's politics today, that the party
Sanjay, the challenge, Congress always tries to sell this as inner party democracy, that where else will you find a political party where there is so much of churn that happens, you know, and
let
then finally
that.
A decision taken. Though I feel that this churn never led to any decision.
Yeah, absolutely. I'll give you an example. Why did I get suspended, right? Because I made some constructive suggestions in a mainstream article in a well-known daily, which was written in the interest of the Congress party. Yeah.
By the way, I don't know if you remember, your last TV interview was right here on NDTV with us, on this program. And then you got suspended.
9:30 show. Yeah. I remember that. And here you have Navjot Singh Sidhu openly threatening the Congress leadership while on a public platform. So I think if today the world is seeing the Congress as a theatrical farce, I think it's something that we need to hang our heads in shame on. I still believe the BJP can be taken on, but the Congress is letting down every voter who voted for us in 2019. 20% of the votes still came to the Congress party. 11 crore people voted for the Congress. And I think today the biggest collateral damage could happen in Goa, could happen in Manipur, could happen in Uttarakhand and Uttar Pradesh and Manipur. And I don't blame Raghav for, you know, the schadenfreude or the gloat that he has for Congress's self-decimation. That's what politics is about. If tomorrow AAP doesn't do well, I will be more than happy to take over that space. That's what politics is.
Okay.
And if Captain Amrinder today is meeting Amit Shah or Mr. Modi, well, that's the way politics is played. I mean, you know, the Congress will say, well, you know, is he ideologically compromised? My question to the Congress leadership is, why do you allow your people to leave you? I don't agree with Rahul Gandhi's comment. Rahul is somebody I've known very well. I've worked very closely with him for a long time.
Rahul making these statements that
right now, if people leave, it's okay. It's not okay, Rahul Gandhi. People should not leave you. I mean, it's the people who make your political party. You can't be so casual. Everyone who leaves you is not a BJP supporter. But, you know, many people are careerist politicians. They have no choices. And I think Rahul needs to stand up and say, listen, we screwed up here, but this is the way to fix it.
Okay.
But will the Congress be so honest? I don't know.
Okay. Mahesh Verma, I want to come to you now. Abhi to ye ek aisi sthiti ho gayi hai Punjab mein. कि मुझे समझ में नहीं आ रहा है कि कैप्टन अमरिंदर सिंह आपके साथ जाएंगे, आपके विरोध में जाएंगे. आज उन्होंने अमित शाह से मीटिंग की, वो अलग गुट बनाएंगे. उनका एक प्रेस स्टेटमेंट आया था जिसमें उन्होंने ये बोला कि मैं नवजोत सिंह सिद्धू के खिलाफ विल फील्ड अ स्ट्रांग कैंडिडेट. ना हाउ कैन यू फील्ड अ कैंडिडेट अगेंस्ट अ कांग्रेस कैंडिडेट? ऑब्वियसली यू विल फॉर्म अनदर आउटफिट. ऐसे में डू यू सी फाइनली सम सॉर्ट ऑफ चांस फॉर योर सेल्फ इन पंजाब?
देखिए, अभी जो राजनीतिक हालात है, जिस तरह का उथल पुथल है पंजाब में, और पंजाब जिस तरह से राष्ट्रीय सुरक्षा की दृष्टि से एक इम्पोर्टेंट राज्य है, वो हमारे लिए बड़ा मायने रखता है. भाजपा की सबसे बड़ी चिंता वहां पर यही है. लेकिन सवाल ये उठता है कि आज जैसे सुष्मिता जी ने कहा और राघव जी ने कहा, उसके बाद संजय जी ने भी जो कहा, उसमें मुझे ऐसा लग रहा है कि कांग्रेस कि जो राजनीतिक रिलीवेंसी है वो लगभग इन लोगों ने मान लिया कि खत्म हो चुकी है इस देश से, और इनकी अब राजनीतिक रोजी रोटी जो बची हुई है वो भाजपा में कहीं दिखती है. लेकिन सवाल यह है कि इसके लिए जिम्मेवार कौन है? जैसे अमरिंदर सिंह जी ने कहा, परिवार और परिवार के जो कुछ चाटुकार जो फैसले लेते हैं उसका ये दुष्परिणाम सामने आया है. अब इस तरह की बातों का अगर आप कहीं सामने रख के बात करेंगे तो कांग्रेस एक ऐसी पार्टी रही, आंदोलन की प्रणेता रही, हमारी स्वतंत्रता आंदोलन की प्रणेता रही. ऐसे ऐसे नेता पैदा हुए इस कांग्रेस में जो एक अपने आप में इंस्टीट्यूशन थे, जिनसे लोग प्रेरणा लेकर जो है आगे सोचते थे, काम करते थे. आज उस कांग्रेस में, उस कांग्रेस को बचाने का जो बात है वो कौन कर रहा है? एक यूनिवर्सिटी लेवल का नेता कर रहा है जिसके आदर्श अफजल गुरु होते हैं, जो कहता है कि घर घर में अफजल हम पैदा करेंगे, जो भारत को
कांग्रेस स्पोक्स पर्सन नॉट फॉर वॉन्ट ऑफ ट्राइंग वी इन्वाइटेड देम, दे डिड नॉट वॉन्ट टू पार्टिसिपेट, बट आई एम श्योर I would have given them a right to reply on this comment that you have made. But Mahesh Verma, if you could conclude.
देखिए, मेरा ये कहना है कि आज के जो हालात हैं, उस हालात के लिए अगर कहा जाए तो पूरी तरह से वो लोग जिम्मेवार हैं जिन्होंने राजनीतिक रूप से पंजाब को जो है मटियामेट कर दिया. अनप्रिडिक्टेबल नेता जो है जिनके पास, सिद्धू जैसा हो, जो किसी का सगा ना.
नहीं, वो बात सही है, बट ऐसा है कि वेयर डिड सिद्धू कम फ्रॉम? ही केम फ्रॉम योर पार्टी, तो जब तक आपके साथ थे तब तक सही थे, अब कांग्रेस में आ गए तो वो अनप्रिडिक्टेबल, अनस्टेबल, अनरिलायबल, सारे अन हो गए. आपके साथ जब थे तब तो नहीं हुए.
संकेत जी, मेरे साथ, हमारे साथ जो थे और उनको, उनकी जो औकात थी, जो उनकी जितना उनको हमें देना चाहिए था वो हमने उनको दिया.
ठीक है, देखिए ऐसे मेनी पीपल फ्रॉम द कांग्रेस पार्टी आर आल्सो कमिंग इन.
हमने उसी लायक है का, हमने उनको पंजाब का प्रदेश अध्यक्ष नहीं बनाया, हमने उनके शर्तों पे काम करना नहीं सीखा.
ओके, राघव चड्ढा.
लेट्स
टॉक अबाउट पंजाब. राघव चड्ढा, डू यू फील द कांग्रेस इन ऑर्डर यू नो बेसिकली ओवर एस्टिमेटेड द एबिलिटी ऑफ नवजोत सिंह सिद्धू? He did deliver the goods. For instance, the leadership in the Congress, Rahul Gandhi as well as Priyanka Gandhi, may have wanted a change of guard in Punjab. That happened. And that ship was steered by Navjot Singh Sidhu. But what next? Look, now there is no captain and no Sidhu also. Where does that leave the Congress?
While politically and electorally, the turmoil in the Congress in the state of Punjab may benefit us. And I say this as somebody who's looking after the affairs for the Aam Aadmi Party in the state of Punjab. I should be very happy. I should be gloating, to you know, borrow a phrase from Sanjay Jha's comment. But as a Punjabi, as somebody who hails from the state, we feel ashamed. We feel humiliated. I don't think Punjab has been insulted so much in the last so many decades. The mandate given by the people of Punjab after a decadal rule of loot and corruption by the Akalis was for good governance to Captain Amrinder Singh and the Congress Party. And the Congress Party has reduced the state of their own party and the state of Punjab to a complete and absolute anarchy. Now, this state is a border state. We have a 553 kilometer long international border with the Pakistan. It's a sensitive state. And you have a state where the elected government that has a good majority, close to 2/3 MLAs in the legislative assembly, going in a complete self-destructive mode. There is no governance in the state. Ministers are not allotted portfolios. Officers are not given charge. And for the last 4.5 years,
do you think that by repeatedly putting stress, and rightfully so, on the fact that this is a border state, do you think the center may eventually lay the grounds for central rule till such time that elections happen?
Look, first of all, if there is a government in place with the right numbers, and if they are in a position to pull off the floor test, I don't see why a president rule should be imposed in the state of Punjab. But it's for the government of India to decide whether there is a constitutional breakdown of machinery or not. I'm not competent to comment on it. But from a political perspective, I can certainly say there is a state of political anarchy in the state of Punjab, number one. Number two, this game of thrones that is being played between one faction and another, and there's a third one, and there's a fourth one, has essentially brought governance and administration in the state of Punjab to a standstill. This is not a Punjab ki khushhali ki ladai. This is satta ki ladai. Kisko satta mile? That is what these Congress people are doing in the state of Punjab, and people can see through this. Lastly, in conclusion, Sanket, people are fed up because you asked this question regarding Punjab. People are fed up with Akali, they're fed up with Congress. There is only one political party with which people have some hope that can actually deliver a stable government, inclusive government. That is the Aam Aadmi Party, and that is what every Punjabi is saying.
Let us see if that happens. But thank you very much to all of you all for joining us. We're stopping for a short break at this moment. News continues on the other side. Stay with us.